Well, viewers, I really don't have much of anything to say at the moment other than thank you all so very much. Thank you all so very much. Thank you all so very much for your comments and your support and your offers for additional support. But right now, I'm good. I think all I can do right now is play the waiting game, abide by the conditions of my release until the 17th of September, and then see what kind of order, if any, I get slapped with at that time based on my behavior over the next 30 days. So we're still in Vancouver. This is still the Pacific Northwest, and really, I hope I don't see any cult members in the area, because to do so would mean possibly that I could face additional jail time, additional conditions of my release, which of course I consented to after having been in jail for 10 hours. I think all of you would have done the same. Perhaps not. It's not really for me to say, but they sure do know how to terrorize a person who has never been to jail before with their introduction to the jail experience, so that they will sign a consent form enabling them to live in fear for the next 30 days until they're brought before a judge again. So I'm supposed to be living in fear, viewers. I've already bumped into two cult members, once at the YMCA, which is just over there, once at the Shoppers Drug Mart, that's a couple of blocks that way. And my heart did start to pound, viewers. I don't think they knew that I've been told that if I come in with, like, I come within 100 meters of them, I could face jail time. I could face being arrested in my pajamas in my apartment again, but nonetheless, that was a reason for panic. So I am trying to live and work and carry on in my life in this neighborhood without bumping into anyone who belongs to the organization that you and I have both come to learn, I think, more than we'd like to know. Because if I were to bump into one of those members, if I were to bump into one of Jehovah's Witnesses right now, and they knew about the conditions of my release, they would be able to take out their phone, take a picture of me, and say that I came within 100 meters of them. And I could possibly have to go to jail again just for that. Just for taking a walk along Robson Street, where clearly they're not set up. No doubt they are set up at Robson Promenade. I'm not going to be going anywhere near Robson Promenade. This is two whole city blocks away from Robson Promenade, I think well beyond the 100-meter restriction. But what if one of the cult members were to just be walking along Robson right now? What if one of the cult members was walking along Robson right now and saw me and, let's say, stopped right there, took out their cell phone, took my picture, called the police and said, "Officer, Stewart violated the conditions of his release today," which really there are about 150 Jehovah's Witnesses in the neighborhood who live and work around here who could do that. So be thankful, viewers, that you're not in my shoes right now. I'm going to be leaving Vancouver in a couple of days, so I won't have to deal with this ridiculous situation that I'm facing, but at the moment, as casual as I might sound, it is not a pleasant experience. To be told to stay away, to keep your distance of 100 meters from people who could really just be anywhere. And if you don't keep your distance, 150 meter distance, from people who could be anywhere, you could go to jail. So really, it's not a pleasant experience being an ex-J-Dub in Vancouver right now, viewers. So, but again, I thank you for your support. I thank you for your offers of additional support. Right now, I'm good. I really don't want to talk to a lawyer. Started from scratch with a lawyer, explaining my entire experience, explaining what I've been doing for 10 months, when I wonder if he'd be even willing to watch one video from beginning to end. So, Really, I've already been receiving incredible legal advice from somebody who's been paying close attention to what I'm doing. He knows who he is. I thank you very much. So, all I'm going to be doing now, viewers, is playing the waiting game and the cooperating game between now and the 17th. And I'll be playing the getting the hell out of Vancouver for 3 days game later on this week. So I will bring this device with me, and I will bring you some footage from somewhere else in North America. We'll leave that, that'll be a little surprise for you viewers. But later this week, the flight is booked, the Airbnb is paid for, and I will be coming to you from, I'll be coming to you from somewhere other than Vancouver later in the week, viewers. So look forward to that. And again, I thank you all very much. So Robson Promenade is just over there, viewers. You can see the Robson Street sign right there. Robson Promenade is just through there. And I did have to take a detour. I did have to take a detour down this street right now because the cult members are indeed set up over there right now. So I am at this moment observing the conditions of my release by coming down, I believe this is Hornby Street right now, instead of even just walking through Robson Promenade right now, because the cult members are set up right there. They are set up right there. So notice how I am going out of my way to not even walk past the cult members. This guy doesn't know what I'm talking about, but I'm going out of my way to not even walk past the cult members right now, viewers. Check these guys out. You guys want to watch a little bit more? Here, watch. I'm now standing on Georgia Street, viewers. I'm on Georgia Street between Howe and Granville. I have not yet turned that corner. But down Granville, around that corner, is typically where the cult members will set up, either inside SkyTrain property or just outside. So I don't know if the cult members are there, but you can see that this is the heart of downtown Vancouver, viewers, okay? There is a SkyTrain station. There is a London Drugs. There is a bunch of shopping that I might be able to do over there. But if there's a cult member, if there are cult members set up in front of Best Buy over there, you guys see Best Buy? If they're set up over there, really, 100 meters means I don't even think I can go on that block. I don't know for sure if there are cult members set up around the corner right here in front of Granville, but if they are, that means I can't turn the corner. I have to go straight and then take a left on Seymour if I want to gain access to the Granville SkyTrain. See? So sometimes they're set up over there. If they were set up over there right now, I wouldn't be able to go into the Vancouver City Center to access the SkyTrain. I would have to access it by going through the underground over there somewhere. If the cult members are in front of Granville SkyTrain, I wouldn't be able to access Granville SkyTrain through the Granville Street entrance. I would have to go onto Seymour and gain access through the other way, which I don't even know if I can do right now because of renovations that are going on. So you see the absurdity of the restrictions that I'm facing right now, the conditions of my release right now. So the judges told me that I'm going to have to live under these conditions for a month. I plan to abide by them. I plan to abide by those conditions of release, viewers. But really, living this way for more than a month, is that something the court is going to expect me to do? to live this way for more than a month. Tiptoeing around in downtown Vancouver so as to not come within 100 meters of Jehovah's Witnesses who set up there, who set up in front of Best Buy, who set up in front of Granville SkyTrain, who set up in front of Burrard SkyTrain, and who set up on Robson Promenade. I wonder if that judge understands exactly what she's done, and if she's happy with herself. I wonder if the cult members are on Granville right now, viewers. If we see them, we're going to have to continue walking past them. You guys see them? Yep. See them there, viewers? I can't even stop. I'm walking along Georgia. I am not going down Granville, Your Honor, but you can see the cult members. You saw them set up. So now I've seen them. I have to go this way. I have to go this way if I want to access the Granville SkyTrain, or if I want to access the bay, or if I want to access any of the underground shops. The judge wants me to live this way. Why? Why do I have to live this way? Because their rights, their freedoms to express their views and invite people to learn about their religion matter more than yours or mine. To chronicle their behavior while not even talking to them and maintaining a safe distance. Interesting. So I am now observing the conditions of my release, viewers, and not gaining access to Granville SkyTrain by Granville Street, but by Seymour Street. I hope this puts a nice big smile on the face of any Jehovah's Witnesses watching right now, that yours truly has to live this way because Jehovah is with you, using Caesar to impose these restrictions on me. So to the Jehovah's Witnesses who are watching this video right now, I wonder what you're thinking to yourself. Yeah, Stuart deserves it. I hope that judge reinforces those conditions and that he has to live that way for a long time. Let that be a lesson to him. You do not speak out against Jehovah's anointed. You do not speak out against Christ's brothers. You go out of your way, and I couldn't even gain access. Look at this, viewers. You know why? Because they're doing renovations in here. They're doing renovations down here. So the only way for a person to access Granville SkyTrain from the street is from Granville Street. So I now have to go. I don't even know where I go now to access Granville SkyTrain, viewers. I have to go through the Hudson's Bay. Amazing. I wonder if that judge were here right now and I were to say, see, Your Honor, the only way for me to get into Granville SkyTrain is through the Granville Street entrance, but the Jehovah's Witnesses are set up in front of there as they are for about 8 hours a day, 6 days a week. So are you telling me that if I want to gain access to the Granville SkyTrain, I have to go to the station just after or just before and then gain access that way? I wonder if she would say, yes, Stuart, and you have nobody to blame but yourself. So I've now gained access to Granville SkyTrain, viewers, after going along Seymour and then down, along Georgia, down Seymour, and then coming all the way around to gain access through here. Because just walking past the Jehovah's Witnesses is something that could end up resulting in me having to go to jail again. So if one of Jehovah's Witnesses came down those stairs, turned that corner, came down those stairs, I would have to, what, run away? Apologize for not seeing them coming or something? Grovel to them in the hope that they wouldn't call the police right now. In this downtown area, in this SkyTrain station, viewers, where you know they set up in four or five different spots all over the place. So these are the conditions that I'm having to live with right now. I'm now at Burrard SkyTrain, viewers. Burrard SkyTrain is SkyTrain station. Burrard SkyTrain is one station past Granville. Typically, the cult members will be set up either just in front of this escalator or to the right. To the right. They're either going to be right over there, around the corner, or right in front of me. I have no way of knowing. I have no way of knowing if they're going to be there. But if they are there, I will be violating my conditions of release, even though I won't know so until I come up this escalator. So are they there right now? No, they're not. No, they're not. Are they over here? No, they're not. See? But if they were, if Jehovah's Witnesses had been here, or if they had been right over here, I could go to jail just for passing through here. Passing through the Burrard SkyTrain entrance and exit right now, viewers. Okay? So, if you were, instead of seeing me standing right there, seeing one of Jehovah's Witnesses standing there, you might have to be watching another video of me talking about my experience being in a Vancouver jail for violating the conditions of my release. And if you were to see, instead of me standing right there, but Jehovah's Witnesses standing there, same deal. So they are set up in Robson. They are set up on Granville. They are not set up here or here. So I guess I should be thanking my lucky stars that by coming through Burrard SkyTrain today, without knowing if they were here, by coming up this escalator and being only able to determine if they were here by doing so, I should thank my lucky stars that they weren't here. Because if they were, I wonder how quickly they would go to their phone to see if they could end up having me be thrown in jail again for violating conditions of my peace bond release. Interesting. No part of the world? Are Jehovah's Witnesses no part of the world? See, those people don't know what I'm talking about, which is fine. See, I think that's what it is, viewers. It's the humiliation I cause for Jehovah's Witnesses, because clearly I'm not afraid to look like quite a fool myself. See, when you get rid of your fear and your anxiety and you just go out and do what needs doing and saying what needs saying, well, A, be prepared to go to jail for your trouble, but B, also be prepared to have hundreds of people come and support you on YouTube and offer you to help you cover any incurred legal expenses, which I've not incurred so far, viewers. I don't plan on incurring, because really, I don't really want to start from scratch with a lawyer explaining my side of the story from the very beginning. Hopefully somebody will just make their appearance known and make things a little bit easier for me in that regard, but if I have to start from scratch with a lawyer, I guess I'll do that. Adrian had to do that, so maybe I'll have to do the same, but I'd really rather not just be a clown passed around between lawyers, judges, and social workers and psychiatrists to be laughed at and then to be invoiced for the assistance. So I'm not really looking forward to that, viewers. Yeah. The good news, though, viewers, is that this, at the moment, is an area free of the influence of the disgusting, hypocritical, lie-spreading, panic-junkie-populated cult known as the Watchtower Bible and Tract Society. So, as a bonus for today, viewers. So, I can't stay and be on cult patrol, so I gotta leave. Because I do know that they could come here. So the longer I stay here, the closer I'm coming to violating the conditions of my release. So I'm going to leave now. I just exited Burrard SkyTrain there, viewers. Yep. This is now Burrard Street. I'm now simply trying to make my way home right now by going up Burrard Street. to turn off onto the street that I live on. And you know what? I have seen the cult members set up right in front of this vacant lot before. I can't tell if they're here right now, but again, just within one city block of Burrard SkyTrain, they could be set up right there. There are no videos, viewers, of me chronicling the behavior of the cult members at this location right here, coming up, right here, but they do set up here from time to time. So, it's a good thing that they're not set up here now, because if they were set up right there on that street corner, right there, viewers, because you see it's a vacant lot, right? So they will set up there. So they weren't set up at Burrard, and they aren't set up here. Of course, it's Sunday, it's not a weekday, they probably will be during the week. But if they were set up there, I would have to go over there to go home, or over there to go home. So lucky for me, I get to just keep walking up Burrard, because the cult members are not set up right here. So I guess I can count my blessings once again, viewers. Okay? Now, this is Alberni, as you can tell, viewers. Okay? You guys see that sign? It says Alberni, okay? And the street after Alberni over here is Robson. Okay, so just to give you an idea of the proximity of the various locations where the cult members will set up, and how I have to maintain a distance of, sorry, got me jaywalking now, and how I have to maintain a distance of 100 meters from those locations if the cult members are set up at them. See? So there's a good 5 or 6 different locations, some of them with 2 each, in this general area, where if I happen to turn a corner and not know for certain whether or not they're going to be manned by a cart, which will be manned by one of Jehovah's Witnesses, if I happen to turn a corner and discover that they're at that cart, I would be already violating the conditions, because that would definitely be closer than 100 meters, viewers. And if one of Jehovah's Witnesses just happened to be going about their business, shopping, working, that I knew and that I served with or that I worked with, then that would also be a violation of the conditions of my release. So I am standing in the center of, really the center, viewers, of downtown Vancouver at the intersection of Burrard and Robson. And if one of Jehovah's Witnesses were to pass through right now, that would result in me going to jail. I wonder if I were to ask one of these people if they would believe that. What they would say. I wonder if I were to say to one of these people, hey, so I protest Jehovah's Witnesses. I don't even really talk to them. A couple of nights ago, I was in jail for 10 hours, and the judge told me that I can't come within 100 meters of them, even though they're set up all over the place. I can't come within 100 meters of any of them that I might know personally when I was friends with them for about 15 years in this area. So if I accidentally turn a corner and they're set up with their carts, or if I accidentally bump into one of them who's just walking around being no part of the world, yeah, right, that would mean that I would go to jail. I wonder if they would believe it. I wonder if they would believe it, or if I would have to show them. I wonder if they would believe it. Or if if I would actually have to show them. That I am to have no contact directly or indirectly with anyone known by me to be a member of the Jehovah's Witnesses. I wonder if they would believe it or if I would have to show them this, viewers. I am standing in the center of downtown Vancouver, hoping that by doing so, I am not violating the conditions of my release. So I'm now about two blocks up from where I just was, viewers. And right here is the Robert Lee YMCA facility. I have a membership to this YMCA. I was just at this YMCA yesterday using the strength and conditioning center. Using the strength and conditioning center. And yes, a cult member who I used to quote unquote worship with, quote unquote serve alongside, was in that strength and conditioning center, and she came right up to me to say hi. What do you think I had to say to her, viewers? Hi? Or get the hell away from me so I don't have to go to jail again? Which I said in, you know, a lot more politely than that. And she was very confused. But then she stayed in the area. She stayed in the area working out, and so did I. But that too could have resulted in my violating the conditions of my release. So if I now come to this gym to exercise, and a cult member is in the same gym, I could go to jail for that as well. Sorry, man. Yeah. So, welcome to life as a branded XJW activist, viewers. So, I live very close to here right now, viewers. You know what? I live close enough from here, viewers, that I can actually come to this gym in my slippers, which I confess I do to use the steam room. Anyway, side issue. Point is, viewers, that I live in this area, I work in this area, I shop in this area, I'm trying to live my life in this area, and now, everywhere I go, just about everywhere I go, I could technically be violating the conditions of my release, because I do know about 150 Jehovah's Witnesses who also live and work in this area, who I pass by all the time. See, who I now have to shun, who I now have to go around the street to avoid, otherwise I end up in jail, viewers, thanks to Watchtower. See, so when one of Jehovah's Witnesses talks to you as an XJW, they could be corrupting the congregation. They could be making room for the demons. But now, if I make contact with one of Jehovah's Witnesses in my neighborhood, just going about my regular business, honestly, minding my own business, if I make contact with one of Jehovah's Witnesses indirectly, the reality is that I go to jail. Never mind, I grieve the Holy Spirit. Never mind, I might lose a privilege of service. Never mind, I might not qualify for a privilege of service. Never mind, I might be jeopardizing my chances of going to Bethel. No, if I do that, I go to jail. Yes, viewers, you still never know what you're going to get when you tune in to early 21st century cult members of the Pacific Northwest.